Hello, everybody. This is Chad from SoundFlow, and today I'm going to be talking about the new transcription features we announced in SoundFlow 5.8. These transcription features live within the Notes package, which is available to download on the SoundFlow store. The Notes package and these transcription features are included with all SoundFlow Cloud Pro and SoundFlow Cloud Business subscriptions, so if you're already on one of those plans, you can use these features today. Once installed, you can select the Notes package from your installed packages list here, and then we're going to focus on the Transcribe Selected Clips commands at the top of the screen here. So you have the option to use some of the factory presets. We have this preset to transcribe to the Notes app. We can also transcribe to Pro Tools track markers, which is what we're going to do first. Over in Pro Tools, we have this simple session here. It's just a video and then a music track and a voiceover that's talking about the history of the cassette tape. So to transcribe this, all I have to do is go back to SoundFlow, hit run preset on transcribe to Pro Tools track markers, and then SoundFlow will take care of the rest. It'll create all the track markers for me. And this allows me to jump around the text really quickly. I can select a piece of text like that. It was bulky and fragile. The cassette was small, durable, and easily portable. I can easily search for a piece of text. So if I wanted to search for 1970s, I can do that. By the 1970s, music labels began releasing albums on cassette, giving listeners more choice and flexibility. Great, so this allows me to navigate my session without having to rely on timestamps or knowing exactly where a piece of the script lives on the timeline. I can just search for the piece of text and jump right to it. Moving on, these transcription features do support multiple languages. So we have these translation VOs here. So I have a Spanish voiceover and a German voiceover. And if I run the same preset on each of these, it will go through and add that text as memory locations as well. So I'll just run this on the German one as well. And now we have all of that text in our Pro Tools session. And even more powerful, because we have the ability to filter this memory locations list, we can filter to just the Spanish voiceover by filtering the track here. We can also, again, search for a specific word in that voiceover.
Por primera vez, la música realmente podía ir a donde tú fueras. A medida que la tecnología mejoró, también lo hizo la calidad del.
And if I wanted to, I could also delete all of these and assign a keyboard trigger to this so I could do Control T, and then I can stay within Pro Tools the entire time and just do Control T on the English voiceover, Control T on the Spanish voiceover, and Control T on the German voiceover. Great, so this allows me to stay in Pro Tools the entire time. I can process multiple audio files and get all of that text into my session quickly. I can also transcribe directly to the Notes app. So to do that, I would just select this voiceover and then use the first preset here, transcribe to notes, and run that. This will add all of the text to my currently active notes project. From this point, I could collaborate with another team member. I could change the category of some of these lines to be ADR or do other kind of collaborative dialogue editing from the Notes app. With the Notes app, we also have the ability to export to a CSV file, so I can export to a spreadsheet on my desktop like this. And then I have the ability to copy any of that text from this spreadsheet to another text editor or maybe to an email to the client, whatever I need to do. Another option for importing to the Notes app would be to select the voiceover and then go to the Import tab. And then from there, you can transcribe the selected clips in Pro Tools. So I'm transcribing the German VO now into the Notes app, and we'll do dialogue as the category. Now I have all of that text searchable and selectable within the Notes app. Finally, you'll notice that there's options to change the language target or the language model being used. To manipulate those parameters, we'll edit a copy from one of these factory presets, and then we can change these parameters to specifically target a specific language like German, or we can search for Spanish if we want to. Then we can also change the language model that we're using if we need a more robust language model. Let's say there's some audio that's harder for the model to decipher, whether it's noisy recordings or potentially sung audio like lyrics in a song. We can use the medium or the large size language models here to decipher that audio. So with the Spanish VO selected here, I'm just going to run the preset with the large language model, and it's going to take a little bit longer to process, but it has the potential to be a little more accurate in the end. Also, it's important to note that these language models are stored locally, and we're doing all of the transcription local to your machine, so there's no audio being uploaded to the cloud at any point during the process. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any other questions about SoundFlow and transcription, feel free to reach out to us on the SoundFlow forum. We'd be happy to answer questions there. And as always, thank you so much for your support of SoundFlow.